Yeah. Rhino, not only physically gifted, but also very ring smart and ring savvy, doing everything he can.
Tough to hold the big man down. Rhino weighs in close to 300 pounds, Ricky Styles. Maybe the strongest athlete in ECW.
Should be noted that your monster is only 25 years of age as well.
And growing every day.
Rhino now thrown to the outside, and on the outside is where the Sandman feels most comfortable.
Yeah, this is where Rhino does not want to be in this matchup. What a personal issues in this match. Rhino is as close to unstoppable, Joey, as a wrestler can get. Look at my Rhino.
Once again, this is ECW versus the network. The Sandman representing ECW, Rhino representing the network.
And they have a message. They have something to prove tonight. They want to find the magic, rekindle the flame, and put on a show these fans won't forget.
These two have wrestled each other over 500 times. Rey Mysterio dropped the Junior, and that's because he was named after his uncle, the wrestler, the original Rey Mysterio, who gave him the okay to take the name and drop the Junior. Again, a huge show of respect by a true legend in Mexican wrestling, the original Rey Mysterio.
Thanks a lot, Joey, but don't ever correct me again. Most of these people wouldn't have known that it wasn't his father, that it was an uncle, until you had to open your mouth. As you said, have wrestled each other hundreds of times. I spoke to Rey Mysterio and said it's been almost 5 years since they've had a contest. swing a chair, Joey.
And that put a screeching halt to the momentum of the Challengers. Champs are down!
This may be the sleeper matchup that steals the show.
And it was Lionheart Chris Jericho that I saw wrestle in Japan. I went to the mad scientist Paul Heyman and I said, you've got to get this guy in ECW. I'm not taking credit for success. I like to think I helped get him to the show.
It certainly does not. He just broke the ring with the force of that powerbomb. Austin, of course, been a mainstay with FMW in Japan for quite some time. One of the most successful foreigners over there, Joey.
He's wrestled as the Gladiator for FMW.
It's clearer now. At last, all
survive and shoot.
The superstar sporting a brand new crew cut. Quite becoming, actually.
Once Taz waist locks you, you know you're going for a run. You don't want to let him get a hold of you.
Austin not letting the fans get under his skin.
Thank you. is not a pleasant individual at the best of times. How'd you like to have him pissed at you?
He's the most miserable man I've ever met in and outside the business.
In just phenomenal shape. Tremendous thickness and muscularity in both the upper and lower body. Especially for a man who had a 4-month layoff with a torn tricep. Austin showing no respect to the champion. He made that mistake once before.
Who is the wildest, who is the most maniacal wrestler? Sabu or myself. And it's
took me a while to admit to myself that I'm not even in the guy's league, Joey. I'm not sure if I could have continued with 100 stitches in my arm. The cut that required 100 stitches. I've seen Sabu impaled on a guardrail. I was sure in a match with me he'd never continue. This guy finds a reservoir of guts and pride somewhere deep in his soul that most of us will never have.
This is all legal because this is ECW. Anything goes.